Okay, let's say that you are on a budget and you're deciding between going for the RTX 3070 used or a brand new RTX 5060, because the price difference between these two are quite close. I know they're both on 8GB of VRAM, and you already understand that this is part of the limitation for this decision. And you have seen previous reviews that the RTX 5060 is more like a side grade. According to Tech Power Up, the RTX 3070 is even 22% faster compared to this new card. However, what I can tell you is that that's not always the case. There are actually certain scenarios wherein this card may be favorable to you. So we're gonna do that. We're gonna run multiple games side by side between these two cards. We're gonna run it on 1080p, 1440p, and 4K. Yes, we've got a lot to go through, boys. Let's start with the first game. Cyberpunk 2077, 1080p ultra settings. And in here, boys, the 5060 is the better card. We get a little bit higher FPS, a little bit higher lows, and we're using much lower GPU power compared to the 3070. We haven't maxed out our VRAM for both cards, although you can see that the 5060 is using more VRAM compared to our 3070. Oblivion Remastered is our next game. And yes, this is a little bit of... Actually, that's an understatement. This one gets a lot of stutters when we're out on open field, which is pretty normal with Oblivion. You wouldn't get any of this when you're in the dungeon or in the city, but in this one, you're getting those stutters. The 5060 is slightly better in terms of average FPS. However, the lows, 1% lows, go to the 3070. It's fine, right? They're very close to each other. Stellar Blade is next. You know, this one's the demo. The 3070 is actually better here compared to the 5060 in terms of average FPS and 1% lows. And something to look in this one as well is you've got a lot of micro stutters here on the 5060. I've run this multiple times. I still get the same results, although it did change when we go to higher resolution. Our first competitive game is Warzone. And in here, boys, the 5060 is the better card. Like, it's just no contest here. It's much better in terms of raw FPS and power consumption. So yeah, we can do this, like, even on the walking benchmark or on the firing benchmark. The 5060 is just much better. Another FPS game is Delta Force. Now, in this one, the 3070 is actually a better card. Yes, they both have high FPS, but the 3070 is the much better card here. Slightly, right? About 3 or 4% better, depending on the scenes, right? About 8% better on the firing benchmark. So yeah, the 3070 is slightly better here compared to the 5060. Next game is Apex Legends, and this one's very interesting. On the heavy action benchmark, boys, the 5060 is actually much more stable compared to the 3070. Yes, they can reach maximum FPS, 300, which is for both on our static scenes. And on our static scenes, the 3070 swings back, right, as the better card, especially on the lows. However, if you play Apex Legends, those heavy action moments is very critical. So 5060 is actually the preferred card here if you're into Apex Legends. Marvel Rivals is next. And in here, boys, the average FPS are pretty close to each other. The lows do go to the 5060. Once again, we have better power consumption, which is a given. The 5060 is definitely a power efficient GPU compared to the older 3070. And yeah, performance-wise, very close, but higher lows on the 5060. Valorant is a game which is more focused on the CPU, but in this case, we are looking at a driver overhead, right? If there's anything, we'll just put this in here so if we could see if there's any difference between both cards. Now, in here, on a heavy action benchmark, the 3070 is actually slightly better compared to the 5060. Now, we're not GPU bottleneck for both cards. When we go into the walking benchmark, which is most of the time what would happen when you're just running on the map in Valorant, the 3070 is actually better. Much better compared to the 5060. Okay, PUBG now, and this one's pretty much of a stalemate, boys. They're actually more or less the same. When we go into the heavy action benchmark, the mortar scene, the 3070 does take the lead a little bit compared to the 5060. Very, very close, right? We've got really high FPS here. Let's see how this one turns out on higher resolutions. Next game is Helldivers 2 in our Gatling benchmark and on our Stratagem benchmark. They're very close to each other as well, although the 5060 does take the lead here a little bit, right? A little bit for the average FPS and the lows, right? So very close, still goes to the 5060, and which is the same, right? The 5060 is still much more efficient compared to the 3070. On Path of Exile 2, this one's pretty close to each other, boys. We have DLSS in here, but that's DLAA. But they're very close to each other, very similar, so not much difference in here. I think one thing that you would notice in here is that the 5060 is now pushing to 145 watts on its GPU power compared to the previous games that we had. Okay, before we proceed to 1440p performance testings, if you'd like to see content like this, subscribe to the channel, boys. Okay, let's move on. 1440p now, and our first game is Cyberpunk 2077. We've got upscaling in here, DLSS, quality, transformer model, and in this game, boys, it's still the 5060 that's the better card, right? It's better compared to the 3070. Not much, but still better and much more power efficient. The GPU power is now pushing to 140 watts now. On Oblivion Remastered, we've got DLSS upscaling in here, and they're more or less the same, really close to each other. Let's move on. And on Stellar Blade, more or less the same, right? Very similar in terms of performance. As I've said, the difference in here for both cards versus the default is just the power consumption, but regardless, they're the same, very similar in our action and even our static scenes. Warzone once again, and we've got the 5060 in here, still getting that lead over the 3070 and Warzone. So for you COD bros out there, 5060 is viable, and we've got DLSS quality upscaling in here. Very viable if you're playing Warzone, or if you're a budget gamer, want to play Warzone 1440p. Yep, this is the one. We're running basic in here, which is competitive settings for Warzone. You needed that visibility. You want minimum clutter, so basic is the setting for in here. And Delta Force, it's the same story. The 3070 is just the better card here compared to the 5060. It performs better in raw FPS and on the lows, regardless if we're on the walking or on the firing benchmark. In Apex Legends 1440p, the results are now more or less the same. Now, previously, the 5060 was better, slightly better on the heavy action scenes, but in this case, I could say that it's more or less the same. And on the static scenes, yeah, very similar, right? Very similar. And on Marvel Rivals, we have better performance now with the 3070 on this 1440p resolution, especially on the lows. Now, it's not much clear here, but on the later part of the benchmark, there we go, right? The 3070 is actually better on the lows. They do look very similar in the initial part of the benchmark. When we go into really heavy action scenarios, the 3070 is the better card. In Valorant, they perform more or less the same, very similar in terms of performance with our heavy action benchmark. We're still not GPU bottleneck here. However, in the heavy action benchmark, very similar. In the walking benchmark, it still goes to the 3070, where there's not much going on. PUBG is also very similar on our running benchmark. However, when we go to the mortar benchmark, this goes back to the 3070. I mean, it's not much difference, but it's the 3070 still takes the cake here. In Helldivers 2, whether we are on a Gatling benchmark or on the strategy benchmark, the performance for both cards is pretty similar, right? Pretty similar. The 5060 could be a little bit better, and sometimes the 3070 is a little bit better, but they're more or less the same. And Palit of Exile 2 1440p with DLSS is upscaling now, quality upscaling. It's actually different. We actually have the 5060, which is performing much better here compared to the 3070. Look at that one, boys. Really huge difference in terms of the lows. That's 120 against 93. So that's a huge difference, about 29% difference in terms of the lows in favor of the 5060. Okay, let's touch 4K. And for this one, we're just going to focus on some games we're in. We'll be a bit relaxing, single player games, and we've just got like one competitive game in here we're in. We might take advantage of the 4K resolution. First game is Cyberpunk 2077. We've got upscaling here for both cards, transformer model, and we're just running at 30 plus FPS for both cards. They're very similar in terms of performance. The 5060 is still slightly better. It's about 1 or 2 FPS better compared to the 3070. Margin of error, maybe, but at this like really low FPS, that's probably definite. It's slightly better. And Oblivion, this is a clear difference now. This is probably where the bus width of the 5060 is now bottlenecking the card. You can see it on the frame times, that's just terrible frame times in there for the 5060 compared to the 3070. Yes, they have very low FPS, not even reaching 60, but that's like a huge difference, right? That's about like 20 or maybe 30% difference in terms of FPS in favor to the 3070. And Stellar Blade 4K, we're getting about like 50, close to 60 FPS for both guys. The performance is very similar still. However, it does favor the 3070 in here, and I think this could be the best width as well. I mean, 60 FPS, it's viable. If you're just playing this game, you're just trying to enjoy the game. It's a single player game, right? And Helldivers 2, once again, we have very similar experience. I think the 3070 may be slightly better here compared to the 5060, but overall, very similar experience. And PUBG, this is now where we can see that the 3070 is actually extending that lead here. Yeah, bigger lead here, especially on the Mortar benchmark compared to the 5060, compared to the previous resolutions where they were really close to each other. And 4K, the 3070 is actually the more favorable card. We haven't, you know, utilized much of our VRAM in here, and in this game you would take advantage of this higher resolution. 140 FPS will be fine. It's a slower paced game, but that visibility that you get from the resolution would be more advantageous in this type of game. So if you're deciding between both of these cards, one very important thing that I would suggest is you look at the game, the performance of your primary game, and then weigh it out. Now, with the 5060, with this one, with a new card, which you can buy for about MSRP, $299, you do get the warranty, whereas in the 3070, if you're purchasing it used, you'll just have to take it like that. So that's something to consider. However, there are a few things that you need to know about the 5060, because when I was testing this card, I did run into some issues which I didn't have with the 3070. So with the 5060, when I was testing Oblivion, I was getting inconsistent frame pacing at 4K, which is, you know, it's a high resolution. And when I was testing it in 1440p, I was getting a lot of crashes, and which I didn't get with the 3070. Now, maybe this could be fixed on future driver updates, but I'm looking at it from a here and now perspective. On Stellar Blade, you can see that on the lower resolution, you do get that micro stuttering with the 5060 compared to nothing on the 3070. I triple checked that and I was still getting the same result at 1080p. It is better on higher resolutions, however. And in Warzone, with the 5060, yes, we were getting better performance in Warzone. However, I did run into situations wherein the game just crashed, wherein compared to the 3070, when I never had any crashes compared to the 5060. So I am not sure if this is with the card or with the driver itself. I'm actually starting to believe that Nvidia drivers, especially for the 50 series, is not good, or maybe it's the card, maybe it's the card. So on our previous video, we tuned this card, we tuned this card. We decreased the power consumption and increased the boost clocks, and actually performed really good. And if you want to look at that one, click this video. Okay, I'll see you guys with it.